find somewhere to rest. I'm lifted in the air. Should we all wake up with nothing but our love? That should be enough. That should be
here. It's good to see you all. Thanks for checking in today, checking out our new little home here of video entertainment. And I'm pretty excited about today. It's going to be a good day, and I'll tell you why, because I got some plans. First of all, I got some closings, I got some showings, I got some contracts coming in, so everything's great real estate wise. I'm really excited about that, but I'm not going to bore you guys with all those details. Nobody wants to see everybody else's real estate stuff, but let me show you what's going on. Check out the new ceiling fan. That's exciting, right? It's got a remote control. Future. And then, look at how beautiful this new painted hallway is that Chris did with the new blinds and the new curtains. I hung the curtain rod, so that's pretty much what I'm good for. And, you know, it perfectly accents the crab room and the guest suite back here. So that's an exciting living room. Is still hurricane preparedness center here, so don't make me bust out the helmet. But everything's in here. This is where we kept everything safe during the storm. As you can see, Mr. Krabs was a little worried. But, and Mr. High Stress here, check him out. Anyway, this is gonna be a fun video adventure for you and I, and Chris. She's gonna be in on it too. She'll be here after work. She's at work right now. She works all day, Tuesday through Friday, so. But when she gets home, she will definitely be jumping in on these. And this is going to be a pretty exciting adventure for all of us. I should sell these suckers. But, you know, I don't want to go through all the hassle of selling things at this point, you know. But anyway, I'm going to head out and I will catch you guys up when we get somewhere cool. And we'll have some exciting adventures together. Just got in the car, I'm backing up right now, but I'm so excited. I finally found the registration that I've been missing all this time. I found it. It was in the glove box. I was just looking at the wrong expiration date. Florida, the registration has like a date that says your plate was originally issued on this date. And I'm like, well, it's like 3 years old, so it's gotta be expired, but it was not, thank goodness. So Jethro looked really sad when I was leaving him. I feel bad leaving the dog during the day, but I feel really good when I get buyers that call me up that want me to go preview houses for them, especially when they're cash buyers and they're properties that I already know. So, all right, hey. This is a warning. The story you are about to hear is factually accurate and unchanged to the best of the storyteller's memory. Some of the content may be too terrifying for the young or the faint of heart. Parental guidance is suggested.
Write it on each other's foreheads so you guys don't forget it. Peacock 8. Or you can write it on your kids' forehead, whatever it takes, guys. I don't want you to forget.
Pretty giant parking lot here.
Alright, folks, last jam of the day, guys.
Kingdom all the time. We never come to this. This is where I come to look my fears right in the face. When I was in junior high school, I took a missions trip to Zimbabwe in Africa. Here we are in Africa, staying on the border of Zimbabwe and Zambia on the Victoria Falls. And they, our tour group, not really a tour group, it was a mission society that had taken us there to help build an orphanage. But they were making plans for us for the end of our trip. And wanted to have a good time. So they planned for us to stay in a really nice resort. That is a big touristy area. It's one of the seven wonders of the world, Victoria Falls. So they planned for us to have a really luxurious hotel to stay in. And then, what happened was, when we arrived, they weren't prepared. Nothing in the resort was ready for us. And I still remember, to this day, how beautiful of a resort it was with a pool. So, we ended up taking all of our camping gear and setting it up in the centralized portion of the resort in Zambia. The counselors that were with us set their equipment up around the outside, and then those of us that were young just put our sleeping bags in a big circle. And it was July, August when we went. So, normal hot season for the United States, but it was a cold season in Africa, because we're below the equator, so it was their winter. So at night, it would get really chilly. And there we were with all of our supplies, including food, everything else you can imagine. And we didn't have a hotel room prepared for us, and we were out in the middle of the African. Well, it was not a resort, but it was still, felt like it was in the middle of the African jungle. So, they had all of our entire group laying around in a big circle, all of the leaders around the outside of us. And since it was cold, during Africa's winter, we had the food lined up along the sides of us in our sleeping bags. Now let me get to the point to why I come to Animal Kingdom without Chris, to A, get exercise, walk for a couple miles because I need it, but also to face my biggest fears. So in the middle of the night, I thought I was having a dream. I couldn't breathe. Something was sitting on my chest. I couldn't breathe and I was stuck. I opened my eyes, I'm in my sleeping bag, and my hands have got my sleeping bag clutched around my neck, but something's holding onto my wrists through the sleeping bag. On top of me, I open my eyes and I am face to face with
this
a baboon.
Is literally grabbing onto my wrist with the strength of 10 men, pulling at my hands to try to pull the sleeping bag away from my chin. I got it tucked up underneath.
Remember, it's cold. We got all of our food in our sleeping bags. He is undoubtedly trying to get to the food that we are stored next to my nice warm body. This thing is looking in my eyes with this piercing anger. He is so mad that he can't get this sleeping bag away from my chin. I try everything I can to scream. I'm scared to death.
This thing has got my wrist. He's squeezing harder and harder. I thought he's gonna break my wrist. He's pulling and pulling at my hands, trying to get the sleeping bag away from my neck. Finally, I get up enough breath. This thing is heavy on my chest. And I get up enough breath to yell out. I finally get up enough breath to yell. When I yell out, this monkey looks me in the face. Sorry, a baboon. This baboon looks me in the face and he screams back. And when he yells, 1,000 other baboons drop out of the trees and start running. Let out what he thought was a call for help from all of my friends. And so he, in exchange, did the same thing. He was fighting me to get into my sleeping bag. He couldn't make it. I'm pushing against his chest with all my weight. He's grabbing my wrist, trying to pull it away. I let out a barely feminine scream, what I could. And then he lets out the loudest scream I've ever heard. And literally, from the trees all around us, thousands of baboons drop from the trees and come running for his aid. I can't tell you how scared I was at this moment. Finally, somebody had woken up around us. One of our leaders was with us, a tour guide expert. He wakes up, jumps up, and he starts yelling. So when he yells, all these baboons let out this yell. Like, we're yelling back and forth at these guys, and it's a West Side Story standoff. And I'm still stuck in this sleeping bag with a baboon on my chest. Well, finally, somebody from the hotel heard the ruckus, came out, fired off a shotgun over the top of our heads, and those baboons scattered like crazy, including the one that was on my chest, and they were all gone. Saved our lives, saved my life. I thought for sure I'd never make it out of that night alive, but turns out the only thing that actually ended up not making it back from that trip was that sleeping bag. Tried to wash it out in the Zambezi River right above Victoria Falls, but it just didn't work out. The sleeping bag had seen better days, definitely. So let me tell you, every once in a while, when Chris is at work, I like to come over and pay my respects because I want him to see me. Hey! I want him to see that I'm alive. I made it through that night. Even though they took my sleeping bag, they didn't take me. The food was ruined inside the sleeping bag, of course. Helps me sleep better at night. I've just about gotten past the part of pooping in my sleeping bag when I camp out at night. Just kidding about that part. It only happened that once in Africa, I swear. But thanks for taking this walk with me through the jungles of Africa again. We visit the relatives of these evil beasts. In there, like it, subscribe it, all that stuff. Let's find out a little bit about each other, what you'd like to see. We're right here in Central Florida. Over there we got Tampa. Over there we got Canaveral. I mean, we got Miami right down there. What do you want to see? What do you want me to do? This is your blog, your vlog. It's all about you. It's perfectly imperfect because there's nothing perfect, obviously, about me. Man, I gotta finish up my push-ups tonight. I forgot. Anyway, I'm gonna head out to the hot tub. I'll wrap it up from there. But meanwhile, it was good to see everybody today. I'm really glad everybody subscribed. Everybody watched this new episode. Hopefully you liked it, you enjoyed it. So take it easy. Facebook, Perfectly Imperfect Florida. That's us. And we'll see you next time, all right? Give us a couple days to build the next one, and it's going to be just as awesome. Take care, everyone. I'm just going to wrap it up for the day. We've had a fun day together. You guys saw a lot of stuff, heard a lot of stories, so try to spread this around. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you really like the videos, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss the next one, because I got big plans, big plans. Subscribe, like, share, the whole thing. Come to our Facebook page, check us out. And if anybody's interested in Florida real estate, this guy. All right, see ya, bye.
Bye.
Bye.